Hope everyone is doing good and safe. I thank OATN in providing me this opportunity to moderate this webinar. OATN has taken wonderful initiative of hosting this iTeach webinar, providing platform for every optometrist who are willing to learn and upgrade their knowledge in the field of optometry. In this moment, I also wish to salute our jawans who had sacrificed their lives at borders. Without them, we cannot live our lives peacefully here. And I'm very excited to introduce our speaker today, Eshwin Sauji. And when it comes to special lens fitting, his craftsmanship is very well known. Eshwin Sauji is a senior optometrist from Nagpur who specializes in the field of contact lenses and is in the practice for 29 years. He's a graduate from Elite School of Optometry, 1991. He's also holding a master's degree in optometry from School of Optometry, Bharatiya Vidyapeeth University, Pune. He's a fellow of LVP. He's actively associated in contact lens education in India and is a lifetime accredited member, a fellow member of International Association of Contact Lens Educators in Australia. He was a senior visiting faculty for contact lenses at Bharatiya Vidyapeeth School of Optometry for 8 years, and he's now actively educating practitioners. Okay. His clinic, Sauji Vision Care, has been voted as India's first center of excellence for fitting irregular corneas by David Thompson Contact Lenses of UK. For the love of education, and he's also with along Optom Nilesh Tite, he has co-founded Masterclass Optometry with the intention of making difference in optometric education in India. For creating awareness about myopia control in India, he was awarded Ambassador of British Indo-Pacific Orthokeratology Myopia Control Academy by International Academy of Orthokeratology and Myopia Control at Vision by Design Conference held at Mumbai 2019. Orthokeratology, a term while I was doing my bachelor's, I remember just reading the definition with the note saying it is out of scope to cover it in bachelor's. I wonder how how Eshwin Sauji has thought of practicing it so early. He's also practicing vision therapy and low vision aids. He is an all-rounder. So let us welcome our Kapildev of optometry to enlighten us in the field of orthokeratology. The screen is all yours, sir. We welcome you.
Thank you, Savita. Thank you very much. I like the title Kapil Dev because he was one of my favorite cricketers. And incidentally, day before yesterday, we were chatting about the Zimbabwe innings of Kapil Dev, 175 not out. Before I begin, my sincere apologies for joining in late. It was unavoidable. There was an emergency. I had to be elsewhere. And originally, I was supposed to take this call from my clinic. But for the sake of saving time, I'm taking this from my home. So I hope you forgive me for this little late start. When Mr. Jyoti Balaji, when he called me and he wanted me to share about my experiences in OrthoK, I was a little taken aback because generally everywhere it's about the fitting methodologies and fitting protocol of OrthoK contact lenses. And here somebody wants to know about my journey in orthokeratology contact lenses. So I thought it's going to be very interesting looking back in time. I think I started this, started thinking about orthokeratology in 2004. So let me just move ahead. I don't think the second slide is needed because Savita Madam gave an excellent introduction. Thank you very much for the same. Few disclosures. As Savita did mention about my practice name, Sauji Vision Care. So I am the proprietor of Sauji Vision Care. So you might end up seeing few logos here and there. Primarily, I'll be discussing about few brands of contact lenses, which are Paragon CRT and Contex contact lenses, but I don't have any commercial interest in both. Contex contact lenses have been kind enough to give me a lunar set of their orthokeratology and myopia control contact lenses both, and I do help practitioners with their urgent orders. Otherwise, I direct them to the distributor. They have an official distributor in India. Also, I'll be discussing or rather mentioning about Midmont corneal topographer. Again, I don't have any commercial interest, but because many of the practitioners, the orthokeratology practitioners, including I, we feel that Medmont corneal topographer is the best when it comes to ortho-K practice. You'll see a picture and a brief mention about the corneal topographer. There's another thing that I would like to mention is, during few of the slides, I might mention money at the cost of sounding commercial, but I want all of you to understand what kind of expenses are involved in starting orthokeratology practice, and that will definitely help you to plan how to charge your patients accordingly. So don't think that I'm too commercial, but I will be mentioning money at some slides. So since a long time, people do odd things to look beautiful, and I'm sure you'd have seen these pictures on the internet. There was a fashion trend in between wherein the elongation of neck was supposed to be making the girl more beautiful, or wearing corsets to reduce your waistline that was supposed to be more beautiful. And in today's time, when we are talking about boycotting Chinese products, I hate to say, but I have to say this, that originally Ortho-K started in China. The ladies there, they wanted to look good and they wanted to see clearly. So they used to have varying weighted sandbags. So while sleeping, you put the sandbags on your eyes and that will flatten your corneas and give you clearer vision without wearing glasses. So the idea, the concept of orthokeratology started in China. Then came some of the practitioners started fitting the regular RGP contact lenses progressively flatter and flatter. So you deliberately go maybe one diopter flatter than the most ideal K reading. And then next week you go another diopter flatter, and week following that you go another diopter flatter. Gradually you start pushing the cornea back and back. That was not a very good idea because there was no other place for area for the cells to swell up, to expand. Generally, ortho-K, as we all know, works by compression of the epithelial cells and expansion of epithelial cells in certain areas. So when reverse geometry contact lenses were made, then we had something called as accelerated orthokeratology, wherein you're given with only one pair. So you wear that pair, go to bed, and in the morning, your refractive error is corrected, and that's the same pair you wear as a retainer contact lens. So today's contact lenses are all accelerated orthokeratology contact lenses. So definitely, as Savita did mention, that I would like to be about 4 steps ahead of my competitors, and I keep looking at newer and newer options in optometry. And orthokeratology definitely was one option on my mind since 2003. And 2004, we became more serious about starting ortho-K practice, and we had the same set of questions which many of you would be having today. How to start? Does orthokeratology really work? Would patients accept it, especially because we are telling the patients not to sleep with the contact lenses on? And today we are now advising orthokeratology lenses to be worn whole night when the patient is asleep. How much of myopia would be corrected, and naturally something like this costs? And then you have the added expense of upgrading your clinic by way of acquiring new instruments. And one last point, which is very, very important, what about complications? So everybody generally is worried about complications with any relatively newer modality. I'm saying newer modality because it's not actually new. It's been there for long, long years. But for India, it's relatively new. So how we started is we looked at whatever brands were trending during those times in 2004 and 2005. And that time only one name came about, which is the Paragon CRT. That was a very well-known name. And they had very good reputation in the market all across the world. So we wrote to them and we requested them to come to India. And you know what? The lucky part was even they were looking at coming into Indian market, because India is a huge market for every potential contact lens manufacturer. So it instantly clicked because they wanted to come to India and we wanted a good lens, and we requested them to send a trial set. Now, some of you would have tried to find out the price of the trial set, especially of Paragon CRT. I think it comes to around 1.5 lakhs in today's time. And somewhere I had read when I was a student, if you want something, just ask for it. So I talked to Paragon CRT people. I said, why don't you be kind enough to send me a trial set? And in exchange of that, I will create awareness about orthokeratology and specific to Paragon CRT lenses. And they instantly agreed. So as a result, I think my trial set would be the first in India. And then after a few years of creating awareness about Paragon CRT, I requested them for an extended trial set, and they were kind enough to gift me an extended trial set also. So I have a complete range of Paragon CRT lenses with me. So what's the first step? The first step was we have a huge database of patients because my dad is in contactless practice since 1969. So we went through the database and we shortlisted patients who were potential clients or potential patients for orthokeratology contact. And we organized a breakfast meeting. Now, it was very interesting. We were debating whether we should do this or not because somewhere I don't like to be commercial, and I thought some patients might take this as a commercial venture, because inviting somebody to a hotel, giving them breakfast and talking about our product, which you eventually plan to dispense it to them. And we printed beautiful invitation cards. In fact, if I had one, I would have shown it to you. It was a card. If you get that card on your table, you will be tempted to open it. In the talk, we briefed them about the various types of refractive errors and the various modalities to correct them. And of course, we talked about the orthokeratology modality of correcting their refractive errors. And it was a very interactive session. And the picture on your right shows the actual menu for that day. It was pav bhaji. The interaction actually proved very useful because there were so many questions, and it was very nicely attended by over 100 people. And the press also was invited. Now imagine you have a contact lens and you need to sleep with your contact lens and your refractive error is gone next morning. Do you think the press would be interested in this kind of news? Of course they would be. So what are the reactions of the patients who visited us on that day? Most of them could not believe it, because they knew contact lens is something to be worn after bath and worn all throughout the day to see clearly. And at the end of the day, remove the contact lens and put on your glasses. So people wanted me to repeat what I was saying because they thought they heard it incorrectly. And the press definitely was very excited about printing this news. So it actually spread like wildfire. The news item was there in all the local newspapers of Nagpur in 2005, just imagine, or I think 2006. People were apprehensive about few things. They were apprehensive about overnight wear, and understandably so, because we've been telling patients not to sleep with the contact lenses on. And here you're advising the patient to wear it all throughout the night. So there would be apprehensions. I believe in the market of United States, I've not never been there, but I believe orthokeratology is primarily opted for because they see reversibility as an advantage. So if something doesn't work, you stop the lens even after 10 years of wear and things come back to its original state. But in India, people wanted something more permanent. They were a little disappointed with the reversibility. They thought, you know, you wear this lens for a couple of months and then your power is gone forever. So this was the initial apprehension. Luckily for me, they thought that this kind of magical lens would be expensive, but they wanted to very eager to understand the cost of these lenses. Some people who had experienced the RCP contact lens discomfort, they thought wearing this lens at the night would be very uncomfortable. But let me assure you, the discomfort is only limited from the time the patient puts on the contact lens and goes to bed. Once the eyes are closed, there is absolutely no discomfort. And typical of Indians, pehle aap, pehle aap. It's a very famous line for North India, at least. Everybody wanted to try on these lenses, but they wanted to try on after I tried it on 5 different patients. So once you do 5 fittings, then you get in touch with us, then we will like to try it on. But nobody wanted to be the first on the list. And when we analyzed the feedback forms, we were pleasantly surprised because all the patients, they appreciated the idea of breakfast meeting. They were excited about the concept, and they also thanked us that Saoji Vision Care, my practice and me, we were very keen about sharing the new developments in the field of vision care. So actually, I was a little scared about this being this patient understanding as a commercial activity, but they in fact appreciated it. Sadly, marriageable candidates and the parents of marriageable candidates were more interested. I'm saying sadly because that should not be the case. And sportsperson were thrilled, and for the right reasons. So how we started fitting these lenses was very simple. Free trials, everything in contact lenses definitely works when you give it free. Although I don't like to give it free, but those were the initial days. And we wanted to try them on because even my experience was very limited, practically it was zero. And both proactive and reactive trials. Proactive is the patients after attending the program, reading about Paragon CRT, checking the YouTube videos, they would actually come and ask to try on these lenses. So those kind of trials work. And then you can counsel the patients and encourage them to try on these lenses. That also works. And if that doesn't work, our standard question was, do you have 8 minutes? Now imagine if you're going to ask any patient, do you have 8 minutes? 99.99% of the patients, they would say, yes, of course, why? What do you want to do in 8 minutes? And we had this beautiful patient information CD, which Paragon CRT had come out with. And we used to show all these patients the CD. And after 8 minutes, you know, they would walk inside your consulting room and say, you know what, I would like to give it a try. So the CD is that good, and it's freely available on YouTube. Higher myopia, definitely there was more excitement because people definitely don't like to wear thick eyeglasses. But unfortunately for us, the myopias which are approved in Paragon CRT lenses are only restricted up to minus 6 of spherical and minus 1.75 of cylinder. So the initial cases that we selected, and for the right reasons, and somebody who's actually planning to start ortho-K practice, make sure you know all these points. Myopes up to about minus 3, minus 4, they are easier to fit. And with some cylinder, but it should be less cylinder. There should not be zero cylinder, and there should not be a very high cylinder beyond minus 1.5. So anywhere between 0.75 to 1.75 would be an ideal case. Avoid previous RGP wearer. For some reason, previous RGP wearer, definitely they respond to ortho-K, but it may not be as fast as a neophyte wearer. Avoid moderate to severe dry eye patients. Although there are some expert fitters in this world who can successfully fit patients having borderline dryness, and in fact, sometimes even with tear breakup times of as less as 2 seconds. Steeper corneas generally respond better, and definitely we need a motivated patient, as true with any other contact lens case. Now, please remember, these are my experiences from 2005 and 2006. Today, it's a different story, but let's talk about what happened in 2006. The average sleeping time of the patients is about 6 to 8 hours, which is true, in fact, even today. And the effect of correction on day one is about 2 to 6 hours. So in the morning, there would be good correction, but that may not last you for all throughout the day. Okay, it also depends upon the refractive error. And full satisfaction is generally achieved within a week's time. Our first experience with follow-ups, the image actually is a true image of my practice, but this is of the recent times, not of those times, but it is just an indicative image. The patient slept very well because they did not have any discomfort, but I did not, because I was so excited about seeing the patient's cornea. I was so scared about seeing whether I would see a punctate staining or an epithelial defect, or whether I would see nice pristine corneas. The first patient tried it only for one night. And second patient, two patients had punctate staining. And please remember, there is a learning curve in this, so we possibly would have made some mistakes. Nowadays, you don't get punctate staining. Very rarely you get it. So out of these two patients, patient one tried it only for one night, and the second patient, the staining resolved with proper lubrication. So possibly the patient was not lubricating the contact lenses properly. And there was no other adverse reaction. There was no serious adverse reaction. One patient had difficulty in removing the contact lens in the morning, and that resolved with proper training and adequate lubrication. So let's look at patient one, 25 years female. This was our first successful Paragon CRT patient, and she went on to wear lenses almost for 6 years. So this lady had 1.5 and 1.75 spherical refractive error. There was no astigmatism. The lenses were prescribed, and overnight vision was definitely better without glasses, but still needed an overcorrection of minus 0.75. Again, I would like to repeat, it was a learning curve, so I would have made some mistakes in selecting this. These days, you don't even need to have the 0.75 overcorrection next morning in most of the cases. So 1 week, there was no improvement, but after 12 days, she achieved full correction, and there was 100% satisfaction. She was very happy to wear these lenses. And I still remember after 1 year, I called her up and I said, there are new contact lenses in the market, which you are supposed to wear it during the daytime. Because remember, those were the days when the upgrades were happening, the silicone hydrogels and disposable contact lenses and all those things were coming into Indian market. And this patient very clearly said, I'm not interested in anything else but this. Patient two, this was never going to be a serious patient, but because I know her personally, she opted to be a trial patient for me, because even I wanted to try them on a couple of patients before I actually try them on actual patients. So she was a 19 years female cricketer. She's quite a famous cricketer. a kind of personality with whom you would like to click a selfie and put it on Facebook. She had only planar cylinder. She had minus 0.5 cylinder on the right side and minus 0.75 cylinder on the left side. Just give me 1 second. Yeah. Overnight vision improved in the right eye. It's very clear because the cylinder is so less, the refractive error is slow, so less, it's bound to improve. But there was no satisfactory improvement on the left side. Remember those days, the cylindrical orthokeratology lenses were not available. These are the spherical lenses. And I was trying to correct the spherical equivalent. I still remember I had presented this case in one of the contact lens conference, international contact lens conference in Mumbai. And one of the expert contact lens fitters from US, he said, why did you even try fitting ortho-K lenses for this patient? This patient was a failure right from the moment go because the cylindrical lenses were not available. She had discomfort at the end of the day and she attributed that to CRT lenses and decided to continue her regular toric contact lens for the left eye. Yeah, the third patient is again a very interesting patient. She is a satisfied patient of disposable soft contact lenses. And again, because I knew her personally, I requested her to be a patient for one night wearing orthokeratology contact lenses. And her refraction was minus 4.5 with 0.75 and minus 4.5 with 2.5. So if you recollect, I had told you right in the beginning that Paragon CRT would nullify or neutralize cylinders only up to 1.75. So the patient selection here is completely incorrect because so much of cylinder is not going to be corrected. But still, I wanted to try and find out what actually happens. And remember, this patient agreed only for my satisfaction. She did not want to try CRT lenses. But right eye full correction was achieved overnight. Just imagine one night, minus 4.5 with 0.75 knocked off. And she was so excited to see clearly without her contact lenses and without her glasses that she wanted lenses at any cost. But unfortunately, at that time, it was not available. And these are her pictures. And forgive me for not so appropriate picture. These pictures are not very good because that time I was, again, going through a learning curve how to click pictures on slit lamps with your cell phones. Or I think it was a regular camera. So then for a couple of years, a good 5-6 years, there was a calm before the storm. We actually worked up about what should be the new product range that we should launch and how we can do it even better. And I'm very happy to say that during the Knowledge Fest too, Knowledge Fest is basically a conference which is promoted by Masterclass Optometry. In my introduction, Savita did mention about Masterclass Optometry. It's an initiative started by me and my partner, Nilesh Thite. So in our second conference, we had Padmaja Sankari Durg, who's my senior at Elite School. And she discussed about myopia control. So we sowed the seeds of myopia control in our second Knowledge Fest. And the third Knowledge Fest was in Goa, which was an international conference on myopia control and orthokeratology. And we had the best of speakers in that conference. And we decided to up the ante. And then we had the Vision by Design conference at Mumbai last year. And this conference saw the who's who of orthokeratology and myopia control. I mean, these are all the top most speaker. They cannot be anything better than the set of speakers that we had. On your left side, you will see Mr. Bruce Williams, or Dr. Bruce Williams, and Dr. Nitesh Barod. These, I would say, are the best orthokeratology lens designers in the world. So they may not be academically so well known, but you give them any cornea, any difficult contact lens, and they would successfully fit an ortho-K on this patient. So again, we repeated the whole thing, but only thing is, this was in the very recent times. We organized a breakfast meeting, or rather, this was not a breakfast meeting. It was a high tea meeting at the end of the day. And we invited Dr. Nitesh Barod. Now, Nitesh Barod, luckily for me, was in India. So we called him to Nagpur, and he gladly agreed. And he traveled 15 hours at the stretch, landed in Nagpur, just freshened up in half an hour, and then he was on stage. Amazing guy, okay? So again, the press was invited, and this was the press coverage in the topmost newspaper of Nagpur. And I will just share with you the experience that we had on that evening and next morning. So this was one of the cases he fitted in my practice. -4 with -125, which is relatively easy, but -7 with -125, now this is a high myope fitted with Ortho-K. And I had given all the patient details to Dr. Barot, and he got the lenses made in UK, and he got it with them when he came to India. And this is this patient's right eye pre-treatment corneal topography. And this is after 1 night of wear, and this is after 7 nights of wear. Now, this is a textbook perfect pattern for myopia control. Now, this patient was fitted with orthokeratology lenses for myopia control, not for cosmetic correction. And this is the left eye, which is the high myopia pre-treatment topo maps. And then after 1 night, and this is after 7 nights. So you can see that beautiful red ring forming, and so much of it is inside the pupil. So this will give an adequate myopia control effect. So this was a stage, again, over 100 people attended that meeting. And for people who are who have fitted orthokeratology lenses right now who are listening to this talk, believe me, this is an ortho-K lens. Now, this does not exhibit the typical bullseye pattern, the black-green kind of pattern, because this is hyperopic orthokeratology. And this patient was a hyperope, and one night, next morning, he saw 6x6 vision. And there was another impossible case, which I would not like you all to try it on. But this patient had about -1.25 with -6 cylinder. I don't exactly remember the power, but somewhere around that, -1.25 with -6 cylinder. And Dr. Barot designed a lens for him. And again, this patient was 6'6 next morning, believe it. So we had this talk at about 8 p.m., if I'm not mistaken, and this went on till about 9:30. Then there were discussions. So we were free from this auditorium at about 10:30. 11 p.m. in the night, he saw all the patients in my practice. 11:30, we went for dinner, and next morning, 7 o'clock, again, we were back in the practice examining the patients with overnight wear. And this person also got to try contact lenses because Dr. Barot was kind enough to design a pair of lenses for him as well. Oops, yeah. So my power is somewhere around -4.75 with -1 cylinder on the right side and 5.5 or 5.25 with 1.75 cylinder on the left side. Now, when I wore this within 3 hours, generally I prefer my patients and myself to wear the lenses 3 hours in the afternoon to see how the corneas are after 3 hours of wear, and then only I allow them to wear it overnight. So after 3 hours, -3.25 diopters of myopia was knocked off, and complete cylinder was nullified. And one night, overnight wear, it was completely gone. I could see 6-6 next morning. And there was zero staining. My corneas were super clean. And remember, of course, one light is my tear breakup times are less than 2 seconds, but still the cornea was clear. The vision was not bad all throughout the day. Of course, in the evening, there was ghosting, and night driving was very difficult. It was almost impossible. After day two and during day three, the day and night vision both improved to 6x6 and N6, and I was actually enjoying specs-free vision. Imagine, you don't need to wear glasses or contact lenses. Ghosting decreased substantially, but still it was troublesome, and I still remember Dr. Barot encouraging me not to give up. Continue wearing, and within about 15-20 days, the ghosting also will go, or you'll get used to it. But somehow, vision by design was coming very soon, and I had to discontinue wearing these lenses because I wanted to concentrate on conference organization. One of the reasons for this ghosting was because aspheric curves were used. Remember, I am a presbyope, and I was a presbyope that time also. So to enable better near vision, aspheric curves and plus bars were added so that I can read better. New pair was ordered with asphericity reduced. It should be asphericity, not sphericity. Asphericity removed or reduced so I can see the distance better. I'm yet to try on those pairs, that pair. So when I discontinued lens wear, the reversal took longer, much longer than I thought. But after 2 days, I thought one night and it should be gone. But after 2 days, it almost reversed. But it required 4 days of reversal for pre-treatment clarity. But overall, it was a great experience. So these were my pre-treatment and post-treatment topo maps. Now you can see the vision over here quite clear on the left side. But on the right side, you can see the foggy vision. That is because of the aspheric curves. And remember, I had large pupils because I'm a myope. My pupil diameter fluctuates from 5 to 7 millimeters. And again, here, see the treatment achieved is beautiful. You can see that red ring. So the treatment achieved is beautiful, but the ghosting still is there. So this ghosting possibly would reduce if we reduce the aspheric curves, if we reduce the peripheral, mid-peripheral plus. So I keep experimenting even today. And now there was this patient whom I would have charged 100 rupees. 100 rupees is just notational. And I spent 500 rupees experimenting on this patient because I ended up ordering ortho-K lenses of same parameters from 5 different labs because I wanted to see the difference in fitting. We also designed on various softwares. Now there are softwares available for designing your orthokeratology contact lenses. So we designed the same patient's lens on different softwares, and we were luckily helped by 2 or 3 different experts. So that actually gave us a very good learning about what lens fits and what you have to do to get better fitting in maybe 1 or 2 tries. We possibly have the maximum number of ready lenses in the clinic. And these would be about 700 of ortho-K lenses, which are ready to be dispensed to patients, thanks to Paragon CRT and thanks to Context Contact Lenses. And even today, I'm learning so much from stalwarts like Dr. Barot, Dr. Nitesh Barot, and Mr. Steve Ernst, who's a technician at Context Ortho-K Labs. Context basically are the inventors of orthokeratology contact lenses. And these are some of the lenses. These are most of it, almost like 80%. So these would be about 500 contact lenses, and plus 200 or 250 more are there, which I'm not able to display here for various reasons. Now, how to start? When you talk about orthokeratology or myopia control, there are so many who are interested. And this is just one of the examples. I think this was the record attendance in my orthokeratology lecture in Palakkad in Kerala. But what I would be happy with is, even if 5% of this audience actually starts fitting orthokeratology lenses, that is my aim. My aim is not to deliver lecture to thousands and thousands, but we want good fitters in India. And this was another audience which we had. This, if I'm not mistaken, again is down south. I think this is Bijan Singh Eye Hospital in Kerala or Tamil Nadu. So let's discuss why orthokeratology. Now, definitely this is a super specialty practice, right? So initially we used to talk about contact lenses as specialty practice, then contact lenses became common and we moved on to toric and soft contact lenses as specialty. Then later on we moved on to RGP contact lenses as specialty, then RGP torics as specialty, then keratoconus as specialty. So we are constantly raising the bar. So what is the highest specialty? It's ortho-K right now. Maybe in future we'll have something else. A lot of patient appreciation is there. In fact, you have to see that moment when the patient comes to the clinic in the morning and the patient is able to read 6x6. Now, these patients, while coming from their residence to the clinic, they would have read all the glow sign boards and all the number plate of the cards ahead of them because they are so excited to see clearly without having to wear their glasses or contact lenses. Now, definitely something like this involves a lot of chair time, and if there is a lot of chair time involvement, you need to charge a bit high to the patient. So there is increased profitability. There is more footfall because you're doing something which is very niche. And please remember, I will tell you why I'm saying more footfall in the subsequent slide. And there is huge amount of professional satisfaction. Everybody is doing refractions. Everybody is dispensing glasses. Most of us are fitting contact lenses and some of us are fitting RGP contact lenses. But very, very few are doing orthokeratology, and it gives you a lot of professional satisfaction. So what are the first steps, the baby steps? You need to be thorough with your RGP contact lens fits. Almost every week, I get a message or a call or a Facebook post asking me to teach them ortho-K fitting. And my standard question is, do you know how to fit RGP contact lenses? And most often the answer is no. So if you don't understand the fluorescein patterns, make sure you be thorough with that before you venture into orthokeratology practice. If possible, you attend a course on fitting of ortho-K because it appears to be simple, but let me assure you, it's not that simple. You need some amount of professional training, to become an expert in that. I'm like 60-70% there, but there is still 30% I need to learn. You of course need to have thorough understanding about the fluorescein patterns and corneal topography maps. Very, very important. Corneal topography may not be required in the initial sitting wherein you have to fit the contact lens, but it is definitely required for follow-ups and to manage a contact lens case. Ideally, you should be doing corneal topography right from day one. And if you can afford to have a luxury of getting hands-on experience of at least 10 fits, then that really gives you the confidence that you require to fit these lenses. So instruments, one of the most important instruments we need is the corneal topographer. But I know of many practitioners who are not getting into orthokeratology because they cannot afford a corneal topographer right now. What I would encourage you to do is don't buy a corneal topographer in the initial stages. You can always refer this patient to an ophthalmology practice, request for the topo maps, and request for the topo maps during the follow-ups also. Now, this wins you on two fronts. One, you don't have to spend money on buying a corneal topographer, and the ophthalmologist also would be very closely monitoring this case. And when he or she sees the success of this case, they would also be encouraged to refer more patients to your practice. Trial sets. If you think you can afford to buy a trial sets are available right from 50,000 rupees onwards up to around, I think, about 3 lakh rupees. So if you want to, if you're very serious about practicing orthoke, you can go in for a basic trial set. Or what you can do is you can make a gang or a group of people who want to practice orthoke in Chennai. And you can share one trial set and one corneal topographer. And most often, if you're about 10 or 15 of you, the company would be happy to give you a loaner trial set, so you need not invest right away. You definitely need to have a yellow rattan filter, because yellow rattan filter will give you more clearer fluorescein pattern assessment. And that really helps, because remember, we are talking about microns here. We're talking about 5 microns, 10 microns, 15 microns. So anything above 20 microns fluoresces. And you need to see this fluorescein, which is beyond 20 microns. So if it is about 20 to 25 microns, there are going to be very little fluorescein, which you need to see clearly, and your rattan filter will help you in this. If you're planning to go into myopia control practice, then you need to have optical biometer. Again, this is not a must. You can always refer your patient to an ophthalmology setup, and you can get your biometries done. Personally, I feel myopia control, not orthoke, but myopia control is incomplete without your binocular vision assessment and therapy. So if the patient has any binocular vision issues, you need to manage that as well as give orthokeratology myopia control lenses. So why should you get into? I think we've talked about why you should get into this practice. One good news is there are at least 3 companies who are planning to start manufacturing or launching their products at economical budget range in the Indian market. So maybe next year we should see a little price drop in the orthokeratology contact lenses. Correctable range, I think I've discussed enough. And there are lenses available for low powers of hypermetropia as well as presbyopia. But I would strongly advise you not going into this practice right now, at least till the time you get adequate experience fitting regular orthokeratology lenses for next couple of years. So risk factors also, as optometrists, we need to understand it is definitely not anything more than your regular day wear contact lenses. So when you're fitting regular daily wear contact lenses, you don't talk about risk, because we know these complications are extremely rare. And even if there are complications, they are manageable. And whatever complications are there, they are never because of contact lenses. It is either because of faulty fit of contact lenses or improper maintenance of contact lenses because of lack of the care and maintenance regimen on patient's side. If you actually see the complication papers on the internet, you might come across few papers which talks about contact lens complications, especially with orthoke in the past and especially with China. That happened because orthoke lenses were indiscriminately given to every patient. There was no patient selection, and it was sold over the counters by opticians who were not trained to fit orthoke lenses. So please make sure you need to have that expertise, the minimum expertise required to fit a successful orthoke case. Without proper training, one should not get into fitting of orthoke. Otherwise, complications are inevitable. So by and large, lenses are very, very safe to be worn. Some tips that I would like to share, which I have learned over the years. You definitely need to have information leaflets about myopia control or orthokeratology, depending on what kind of practice you want to start. And you need to organize for counseling sessions in your clinic. It may not be as big as I have shown you in my presentation, but it may be small, 5 set of parents coming to your practice with their kids and learning about orthokeratology or myopia control. You need to develop your own patient consent forms and examination protocols. Care and maintenance information has to go to every patient who is walking out of your clinic. And you need to have follow-up sheets. So I will just show you what I have in my clinic. Just give me 1 second. Or maybe I will stop sharing the screen and then show it to you. At the end of the presentation. Some of the practitioners, in fact, one of the practitioners was kind enough to share with me his Excel sheet. Now, he's made a beautiful Excel sheet which can monitor the myopia progression and what happens when you change the modality of myopia control. I will show that to you in the next slide. And you can even have patient information leaflets. So this is that Excel sheet. This is not mine. The patient is also not mine. But if you see over here, the patient did not opt for any myopia control. So the myopia went on increasing, and this was the average increase. And here, possibly the patient went in for glasses and atropine or multifocal soft contact lenses with 0.02% atropine. And you can see the rate is reducing, the rate of myopia progression is reducing. So this is very easy for us to keep a tab on the patient and for the patient to understand that your method of myopia control is indeed working. There are beautiful softwares available for designing your own lenses. So if you're not very happy about fitting the lenses of your trial sets, then you can design your own lens based on your refraction, your keratometry, your corneal topography, and so many other parameters. So you have RGP Designer, then the Wave software, iSpace, and I'm sure there are many more which I'm not putting up here. And you also have built-in softwares on your corneal topographers. So either you can gain expertise in designing your own lenses, or you can talk to the lab and give them the parameters and they will be happy to design a lens for you. So you can virtually see the fluorescein pattern about how the orthokit fit is going to look like, and you can modify the edges. You can modify what you want over here. You can understand how many microns is the pooling here and how many microns is the pooling over here. What you could also do is, if you really want that power start or the booster, initial booster. This is our experience with respect to binocular vision clinic, and you can do that for your orthokeratology clinic. Now, people in Nagpur are used to my way of examination. But if I tell my patients, you know, somebody from Chennai is coming, he or she is an expert in binocular vision, then they're going to be more happy about getting themselves examined by this expert. So similarly, you know, you in Hindi, you have that saying, you know, ghar ki murgi dal barabar. So people who are from the same city, the patients don't often value their examination. So you can get an outsider and start myopia control practice, and that gives you the initial boost. So our experience with binocular vision setup is, are you able to hear me? Hello?
Yes, sir. You're clear, sir.
Okay. Yeah. So my experience with binocular vision clinic is because we do a lot of binocular vision cases, but the high-end binocular vision practice, we're not really qualified to do that. So we get an FCOVD, again, my junior from Elite School of Optometry, Niveda Santaram. She comes once in a month and she examines patients. So we were not very sure whether this arrangement would work or not. But today the patients call up and ask, you know, when is Dr. Niveda's next visit? So that is the kind of excitement and happiness amongst the patient. So eventually you can continue with this arrangement, or you can learn the tricks of the trade and start your own practice. So where do I see myself in future? My practice is very small, but if I can have these 2 lounge chairs in my clinic someday in future, wherein the ortho-K patients would be trialed on, so they can just lie down and listen to audio about what ortho-K is and what myopia control is, and how this is going to benefit you, then this would be amazing. So this is where I aim to go in next couple of years. Please don't think LASIK is a competitor. LASIK, in fact, can be a very good clinic who would refer patients to your practice for orthokeratology. If you remember seeing my topography reports, now those were from an ophthalmology clinic because that time I did not have a corneal topographer. Today I have a Medmont corneal topographer. So that ophthalmologist was so excited to see my corneas clean and my power gone. And then I briefed him about myopia control and he said, you know what, this is going to be great. So you can control the myopia till up to -5 or -6. So LASIK becomes very easy for me when the patient reaches that age. So he instantly understood the advantages of myopia control. And that clinic now has become a referral clinic for my orthopedic patients. So people who are listening to this talk right now, I would be very happy to help you if you wish to start a myopia control or an orthokeratology practice. Please remember orthokeratology for cosmetic correction and orthokeratology for myopia control varies a little bit. So the lens design is different for these two. So I can help you in connecting with the distributors of various companies. To the best of my knowledge, there are about 6 or 7 distributors from various brands of orthokeratology contact lenses in India at the moment. You could even attend the Knowledge Fest conference organized by Masterclass Optometry. Invariably, myopia control and orthokeratology are going to be an important part of this conference. I can help you to be an observer in the various ortho-K clinics all across India. And if required, we can find some practitioners who could handhold you and do case on WhatsApp or social media. So this is what we regularly do to people who are very much interested in fitting ortho-K lens. So these people, they send us their details in a prescribed format. So I send them a format, they fill in all the details, and we send you 3 pair of contact lenses for your patient. And most often one pair would fit. And if it doesn't, then we need to customize that lens and we guide you with the way forward. And up till now, we were not charging for this. But then my staff recently pointed out that we were actually spending so much money on couriers and we are not gaining anything out of it. So it's not my business to actually do this, but you could get in touch with the distributor and the distributor would help you. But one-off cases, we'll be very happy to help you with managing your cases. So remember, I said you get more footfall when you venture into specialty practice. Now we've done cases from Salem, New Delhi, Ahmedabad, Mumbai, Bhubaneswar, Ajmer, Pune, Chennai, Meerut, and Balaghat. Now, these are patients out of Nagpur. Now, just read there, New Delhi, which is the topmost metro, that is covered. Mumbai is covered. Chennai is covered. So it's only Kolkata which is left. So I get patients from all across India. And this special patient from Ajmer, now he is a peon in a government office. And he's got unilateral refractive error. So he was surfing once and he came across orthokeratology. And the concept of orthokeratology really got him interested. And he booked a ticket for Nagpur, came and met me. I said, you don't really need to be fit with an ortho-K lens because one, it's going to be expensive and you don't need it. Your other eye is normal and your refractive error is very, very less. So why do you want to spend money on ortho-K? He was point blank in telling me, can you fit me with a lens? This is the money. So you'll be surprised to know that people come from all across, from various backgrounds. Unfortunately, most of them come to pass the medical exam, which they have to clear before going in for a government job. Now, that practice is a little unethical. So you have to take a call whether you would like to fit these patients or not. So don't think orthokeratology practice is difficult. Make a start and you'll be surprised to see how many people are willing to help you to get there. So I hope some of you, at least maybe 5% or 10% who are attending, would get inspired to start an orthokeratology practice. So this is how my journey on ortho-K contact lenses was. And I feel that it has taken me 15 years to reach where I am today. Now, with these tips, you should be able to reach wherever you want to reach within 15 months and not 15 years. So a captain of the ship or captain of any team is only as good as his team. So I would actually like to acknowledge this person here, Mr. Rohan Kolte. He helped me to design the most thorough myopia control examination protocol. So how we designed this is we sat across the table and we listed down the examinations which would be required for myopia control. I do more of myopia control and orthokr about only 20% of my practice. So we listed down the tests, and then we made a sample protocol, and we circulated that sample protocol to all the experts around the world. And we incorporated their comments, and it went on becoming better and better. And today we have possibly the most ideal contact lens examination protocol for myopia control in the world, because it is approved by who's and who across the world. And he is Mr. Sumit Bajaj, who along with Mr. Amarjit Verma helped me to design my binocular vision examination protocol. So that's again very, very thorough. And these two, Sudhanshu Dhanotia and Rishabh Gupta, they are my right hand and left hand with respect to fitting orthokeratology lenses. In fact, if there is any inquiry from our station, I used to just give them the printed protocol. This is the refractive error, this is the key reading, and these are the corneal topography maps. And they used to give me those three pairs with all instructions written on them. So I did not have to do anything. So these people are that thorough in orthokeratology. So with that, I would like to end my talk. And if there are any questions, I'll be very happy to answer them. Or you could anytime email me. My email ID is yashwantsawji@hotmail.com. And Yashwant is spelled as Yeshwant. There is no H. Thank you.
So nice of you, sir. It was too good listening to you, to your experience. I was actually thrilled listening to your experience.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Actually, sir, you have already mentioned that you could help with the observation ship. Mr. Yes. Saravanan Optom has asked that he has said that he is a master in optometry and he lacks training in orthokeratology. And he asked whether there is any program you could offer or any observation ship you could offer.
See, I personally don't have any program, but there are a lot of theory programs available which you can do online. You're free to come to my practice and see a couple of patients. You're most welcome anytime. But these online theory programs you can do to understand the orthokeratology theory, or you could just try and Google it and read for a period of 10 to 15 days. That should be good. But if you get a chance to attend Vision by Design or Knowledge First conferences, which possibly are not going to be held this year because of Corona pandemic, but maybe next year, mid of next year, then it'll be the best thing because you get to hear so many experiences all across the world. Feel free to write to me anytime and I'll be very happy to answer to you on email.
Thank you, sir. And Optom Sanjay has said it is challenging and interesting to fit an orthokeratology lens. And he's asking whether you are wanting to discuss any case which you were like feeling very satisfied after fitting orthokeratology.
I think I've already discussed two cases which I was very satisfied with. The first case, which was very successful because that patient wore lenses for almost 6 years. And this was way back in 2005 or 2006. I don't exactly remember. And the second case, which Dr. Nitesh Barot fitted, the girl having -4 and -4.75 and -7 bar. Now, I should have actually recorded that moment because in the morning, when the patient's mother came and she saw that her daughter was, this patient's mom is a hyper worried kind of a person. So when her daughter could read 6-6, she actually burst into tears and she had to be consoled by four people. And she was so happy and she was so excited about it. So there are some interesting cases, but because this presentation today was limited to walking you along with my journey on ortho-K contact lenses right from 2004 till date, I did not prepare any cases, but one-on-one, I'll be happy to discuss with you.
Okay, sir. That's nice. And Optom Preeta, she has two questions. She asks whether you can share any experience in fitting ortho-K lenses in progressive myopes.
See, when we are talking about myopia control, it's all progressive myopes. So as I said, you know, 80% of patients who are coming to my practice are for myopia control. And if you remember those topography maps, you see that red ring. So all you need to do is you design a contact lens in such a way that about 25 to 30% of that red ring falls inside the pupillary area. Then myopia control effect is better. I mean, this is one of the key factors. Otherwise, the lens differs a little bit, but most of these patients are for progressive myopia. And what she talk about results, if you're asking me about results, then it is too short for me to comment on the results, because unfortunately, none of these patients, they really keep up their follow-up appointments, although we are trying our best, but it does work.
What she was asking is, like, she asks whether the lenses has to be frequently changed as the...
No. Yeah, sorry, Savita, continue. Did you finish?
Yes, sir, I have finished. She is asking whether the lenses has to be frequently changed as there is a...
Yeah, it's only one lens. There is only one lens, and this lens is the one that you fit on day one, and that ideally should continue up to 1 year. But most of our patients are successfully able to wear these lenses for 2 years. And because of change in the power, you need to change your lens. This kind of situation is extremely rare, at least because the life is restricted to 2 years. According to me, according to the companies, it's only 1 year. So every year you have to replace the lens. So anyways, the life of the lens gets over before your power changes.
And there is also a second question, sir, from her. For an existing RGP or soft CL wearer, how many days should they discontinue wearing CL before they undergo ortho-K workup?
Good question. I really don't have the most accurate answer for this. But I would like to keep a watch on their corneal topographies. The day their corneal topographies stop changing, or at least wait for about 15-20 days and then attempt fitting. Remember, you're most often fitting these lenses from your trial sets. So let's say you fit a lens and then you realize it's not a very accurate fit. You can always take back this lens and give a better lens. So it's called as dispensing diagnostic system or diagnostic dispensing system. So you use it for diagnosing and you use it for dispensing.
And Optum Kumaran, sir, is asking, can you say the contraindications of ortho-K lenses?
Contraindications, as I mentioned in one of the slides, if there is too much of dryness, then you should not fit. And if the patient has an allergy or predisposed to any allergic condition, maybe you can avoid. And a person who's not properly maintaining contact lenses, because remember, these are sitting, any contact lenses are sitting very close to the patient's corneas. So you need a patient who's going to maintain the contact lenses the way you're advising them to. All the complications happen either because of faulty fit or because the patient is not maintaining contact lenses properly. So that is why case selection is very, very important.
Optum Preeta has another question. Mm-hmm. Pathological myopia as contradiction. Is there any contradiction for pathological myopia?
See, Preeta, pathological myopia, again, is a very, very confusing area or a very gray area. Now, most of the practitioners feel that orthokeratology for myopia control will not work for pathological myopia. So myopia is beyond minus 10, you should not even attempt fitting. Whereas there are some practitioners who feel that there is nothing much we can do for these patients. So if at all orthokeratology for myopia control is going to help, why not give it a try? There is no harm. The only thing that you can do is, let's say you get a patient having minus 15, you do not correct minus 15 because that's going to be slightly risky. What you can do is you can correct up to minus 4, minus 5, minus 6. That is all correction that you need to control myopia. So myopia control effects are not going to be any better if you correct one minus 10 versus minus 5. So aim to correct minus 5 and give the balance correction in terms of glasses.
Okay.
So there is a gray area. You may fit, you may not fit. But generally, most of them, they say that it doesn't work in pathological myopia.
Myopia. Okay. And Optum Lata is asking, you mentioned about consent. You have asked, You have taken consent from the patient. So she's asking whether there is anything to be done legally from our side.
I really don't know. In fact, whatever consent form that I have designed, I have taken legal opinion also. But then if you talk about legalities, right now we don't even have that legal stamp saying that, you know, contact lenses can be fit by optometrists. That itself is a gray area. Forget about ortho-K. So at the moment, it's a gray area, but very soon there will be some clarity on it because the AHP bill is on its way and we should have some clarity. So that reminds me, I would like to show you, this is the file that patient carries, okay? So every ortho-K patient or every specialty contact lens patient gets this, and that is how it looks from the back. These are the specialties or the optometry faculties that we practice, and the patient's details are here. And this is a little bit about a story about how my practice started. So patients get familiar with my practice and my own self. And this is that myopia control protocol, which I was discussing about. So it's quite thorough, and we need about 1.5 hours to complete this. And this is the format which I want my practitioner or the practitioners to fill in if they want my help. So all the details are given here. This is the welcome letter given to the patients, welcoming them to orthokeratology, world of orthokeratology, and my practice. These are the instructions, how to maintain their contact lenses and how to wear and remove their contact lenses. And these are my fee structure. So how much the patient has to spend on an ortho-K pair and examination, all that is very clearly explained to the patients. And this is the agreement which they have to sign on every paper before we deliver them with contact lenses. So it's a 3-page agreement. And this is their photo release forms, because you end up clicking so many interesting photographs which you would like to share on social media. So we get an approval from them to share their photographs. Of course, it goes without their pictures and names. And these are the set of instructions which every contact lens wearer has to follow. And this is the myopia control booklet, which I give to all my potential patients who need myopia control. So this is completely written by me and designed by me. And this is a small leaflet that we give to all our patients who need binocular vision exam. Now, before any of you ask me a copy of this, all this material is copyrighted. And all this will be available freely, but after 1 year, not now. For again, various reasons, which I cannot reveal right now. Yes.
There is a few questions about the care and maintenance and solutions to be used in ortho-K lenses.
Okay, at the moment, I'm recommending Boston Simplex, but there are better solutions available all across the world. Unfortunately, we don't have them in India. So Boston Simplex right now is your best bet.
Aishwarya is asking whether are ortho-K lenses available for regressed myopes post-refractive surgery?
It's a very tricky case. Yes, they can be fitted, but then I would definitely not advise you to try in the initial stages. I think we should leave it to designers like Dr. Barot and Dr. Bruce Williams, who can do a fantastic job on these cases. Possibly we need another 10 years to reach there.
There is one question which is asking about cylindrical correction. How much maximum cylinder can be corrected through orthokeratology?
See, ideally, if you talk about the ready-made or the branded contact lenses, they would say about 1.75 to 2.25, not beyond that. But remember, I told you, Dr. Nitesh Barot fitted a case having minus 6 cylinder. But definitely, I would not advise that. You stick to about minus 2, that should be a safe limit.
Okay. There is one question, which is better to fit, axial myopia or refractive myopia?
Again, good question. But because this talk was not originally about fitting lenses, it was about my journey. I did not have those examples, but why not fit it for every myope if you want, if your final aim is to give myopia control? Remember, we are actually wanting to nullify the hyperopic defocus. And hyperopic defocus can be done, can be corrected using orthokeratology lenses very well. So why not give it to everyone? Whatever benefit we get, that's a benefit.
Okay, sir. Optum Kiran Kumar is asking whether it can be used for mixed astigmatism.
If you ask me, the most ideal answer, no, it cannot be used for mixed astigmatism. But if you ask people like Dr. Bruce Williams and Dr. Nitesh Barot, they can correct this. I have seen it.
Okay.
See, you know what is your final refractive astigmatism. You want to nullify the refractive astigmatism, and you have the corneal curvature. So you design the lens accordingly and correct the refractive astigmatism. So if you have to write this in an exam paper, you have to write, no, it cannot be corrected. But tactically, you want to do it. If you're an expert designer, you can do it.
Okay.
Though it's not advisable.
Okay. Optum Sanjay is asking your inputs on EDOF lenses.
Extended depth of focus lenses, I really don't have any experience with that. So it would be inappropriate for me to give any comments on that.
And Optum Chitra is asking, you have mentioned about night driving glare. She's asking how to overcome it and your suggestions about it.
See, very simple. The night driving glare was only because the designer, again, Dr. Barod, put the excessive plus bar there so I can read better. Remember, I'm a presbyope. So if I have to see clearly for distance and near, I need some plus bar to be generated in the mid-peripheral area. So because of that and because of my large pupil, the problem of night glare was there. So either I can move on to monovision, but in orthokeratology. So this eye is corrected for distance and this eye is corrected for near. That is one option. The second option is I can constrict pupils using some eye drops. That will give me clear vision. Or the third option is I stick with distance correction and I wear on-top glasses for reading. So that way I can correct myself.
Okay. There is one question.
Savita, right now I have lenses designed for my own cornea without the plus power. Okay, that's distance correction. I've got two pairs. I've got three pairs of mini scleral, toric, multifocal contact lenses designed for myself. And I've got some special ortho-K lenses designed for myself. So I've got about seven pairs to be tried on. So I do all these experiments on my own cornea.
Yourself first. Yeah. Yes, sir. Even I'm on that idea. I'm a myope too.
Yeah.
Okay. In the absence of topographer, can we take central and peripheral readings and then of four quadrants of keratometry and then go about fitting an ortho-K lens?
You don't need to do that also. Remember, I said while fitting, it is okay if you don't have topography reading. Although, don't quote me on this because ideally, yes, you need it. But if you still don't have it, you can fit a lens. But to follow it up, because you need to understand if the treatment zone is central or it is displaced. How would you know that if you don't have your baseline topography readings? So topographer is a must. You should have it or you should refer the patient to corneal topography. Keratometer will not help you there.
So I have a personal question, sir. Many nowadays the softwares have come. We can put it in a tab and then work on it. Many softwares have come for field of vision, testing field of vision. Is there any thing available like that in topography?
You mean somebody else is doing topography somewhere else and you are trying to analyze it somewhere else, right?
Like any picture we can take and then with that we can upload it in the software and then calculate it, anything of that sort?
It works like that only. So if you have a Medmon topographer in Chennai, you take a picture and you send me the MXF file and I can open it on my topographer as if I have taken that topographer reading. So I can do whatever changes I want over there. So it opens my topographer as that my patient is my own patient. And that facility is there in all the corneal topographers.
Okay. What is the best topographer of India as of now and which can be, any beginner can take it?
Only one.
Medmont. Your suggestion.
Medmont E300. I showed you that picture. MEDMONT, Medmont E300 is the model that is best for orthokeratology practice.
Okay, sir.
Although, unfortunately, they are not going to give me anything for saying this.
will amber matic night vision glasses helps to protect glare in this case?
Not really, not in this particular case, because the glare is not because of the light, but it is because of the plus bar which is generated on the cornea.
Okay.
So it will not help.
Savita, okay. Before you take up the next question, there are two questions people wrote to me in WhatsApp, which I forwarded to you. Probably, put the question across to Yashwan, please.
In WhatsApp, sir?
In your WhatsApp.
Just a second, sir.
No, if you have any question, you take it up there.
Yes, sir. Fine. Do we need to advise any lubrication once ortho-K lens is removed after waking up as to good surface regularity for initial minutes?
good question. Not really required, but then if there is any difficulty for the patient to remove the contact lens, because sometimes, you know, the contact lens can remain stuck to the cornea. So if that is happening, then you can put lubricating drops, but please ensure that it is not a very viscous drop. Avoid viscous drops. It has to be more watery, and ensure that the lens is freely moving, and then remove it. That is all that is required. You don't need to put an additional lubricating drop once the lens is removed.
Okay. And what is the age factor and influence of orthoke over it?
Can you rephrase that question?
It has been put like that. What is the age factor and the influence of orthoke?
Or possibly the person wants to ask at what age we start fitting orthoke lenses. If that is a question,
might be that
asking,
or what age can be more effectively we can fit the orthoke lenses. Might be
very simple, as soon as possible. You don't want that myopia to go on increasing if it is for myopia control. Okay, if it is for myopia control, you want to start as soon as you are confident that the patient and the patient's parents can take good care of contact lenses. My youngest patient is 6-year-old. But okay, there are some people who have started patients on when they were 4 years old also. Okay.
There are a few questions asking about investment, initial investment, least investment involved in starting orthoke practice, mm-hmm, and cost of orthoke lenses for patients.
Okay, the least investment is zero. You don't need any investment. Why do you need investment? You're already fitting contact lenses. So whatever you need to fit contact lenses, that's already there in your practice. All you need is corneal topography and a trial set of orthoke lenses. I told you, you can refer your patients elsewhere for corneal topography. Just have an arrangement with some ophthalmology clinic. So wherein whatever the ophthalmologist is going to charge, you can bill it into your consulting fees to your patient. Because remember, you might need about 3 or 4 corneal topographies. So you work up a deal with the ophthalmologist and you charge that in your consultation fees. Okay, that's one thing you can do. Or 5 or 10 of us can get together and buy one corneal topographer. And if that is the case, you could go in for a portable corneal topographer, so which you can carry in a small case. So that's another option. And if you are 10 of you or 5 of you, then the company would be very much interested in your group and they would be happy to loan you with a trial set. So I think you just have to ask and I'm sure they will give it to you. So initial stages, I would not request or I would not ask anybody to invest. Once you're confident that you're getting patients, once you're confident about fitting orthoke lenses, then maybe you can invest.
Okay. There is one question. What is the scope of orthoke practice do you see in case of private practitioners visiting multiple clinics?
Well, the scope is into 5. Now, I am one practice. If I am doing so many cases, if I start moving to 5 practices, I just multiply that by 5. All you need to do is encourage people to go in for orthoke and counsel patients. Patients are there. A lot of patients are there. So if you talk to 100, 10 may be ready to come to your clinic for counseling session, and out of that 10, maybe 5 will actually go in for trials. So the more practices you visit, the more number of patients you will get, that's for sure.
Okay. And there is one question. Myopia is controlled by orthoke, but what about the retinal changes?
Why do retinal changes occur? Retinal changes are directly related to the amount of myopia. So if your myopia is high, your retinal changes are going to be bad. If your myopia is low, your retinal changes are going to be less. So that is exactly the reason why we would like to control the myopia. So if you keep the myopia to below 3 diopters, and if you keep the axial length to below 26 millimeters, then your retinas are going to be relatively safer. And how you need to calculate, now again, this is going more technical into fitting of lenses, which I did not want to tread on. But how you need to calculate is, what is today's axial length and what is the age till which the axial length is going to increase? And we know the average increase of axial length per year. So you calculate, by the time today's patient is going to be 20 or 21, what would be his or her axial length? If that axial length is going to be lesser than 26, then I'm okay not fitting an orthoke lens. But if that axial length is going to cross 26, then definitely I would like to put this patient on myopia control. So even if you encounter a patient who is, let's say, 4 years old and having emetropia, I'm saying emetropia, what should be the refractive error at that age? It should be a little bit of plus. But because this patient is having emetropia, this patient could be an ideal candidate for myopia control.
So even for emetropes at a younger age, can be patient.
Why emetropes? Why emetropes? In fact,
because they had to be. Yes.
No, but there was one optometrist. He said he would put the patient on myopia control even if a 4-year-old kid would be having plus 0.5 of refractive error. Now, initially, it may not agree with somebody. You know, kid is having plus 0.5 and you're putting the patient on myopia control. Because we know the emetropization has happened a bit too soon. So this patient is going to go on the minus side. So why not put him on myopia control straight away? But these are individual choices.
Choices.
Savita, can I ask a few questions?
Yes, sir.
Please. Yes, sir. This particular question is from me. You said very clearly mild to moderate dry eye patients are contraindication or we need to be a little careful. Is there any specific tool you recommend to measure their dry eye status?
No, I don't. In fact, the best measure is giving a trial. So even if you feel that there is a borderline dry eye, you give a trial. If there is no staining, if everything is working on fine, why not dispense the lens? Like in my own case, my tear breakup times are lesser than 2 seconds. But the day I wear or any, I wore the lens almost for 10 days. None of the days my cornea had even a single SPK. It was pristine. It was very clean. So it is not really dependent on dryness. But please remember, the lens is acting by way of pushing the tears. And the tears are exerting that force on the epithelial cells. So you need a decent tear layer. But if you still don't have a decent tear layer, there are designers who would accumulate the tears in the mid-peripheral area of the contact lens and help you to even get rid of your dry eyes. Now, this is ideally not a good thing for me to comment on a public platform like this. But when my lenses were designed, the designer said your dry eye would be much better. You would be relieved of your symptoms. And I don't know whether it was psychological, but I was much better. The dryness had almost gone.
Sir, one thing to mention from my side. I'm also undergoing a course from orthokeratology. And in that course also, it has been taught that dry eye can be somehow, it can be cured by orthokeratology lenses. Some patients are getting...
you're actually collecting the tears there. So your symptoms become much less. But okay. Then you ideally you need a good tear layer for effective orthokeratology.
Okay. The other two questions, not from me, it was asked by one of our alumni who is practicing in Chennai, in Tamil Nadu. She is asking, since you have mentioned orthokeratology is a super specialty, who can practice? I know you will be answering anyone can start, but there can be anything like a bottom line or something. So would you recommend who can start first? Second question, since the RGB lens fittings are not being properly or it has been kind of given up because of the oversaturation of our soft contact lens. Suppose students' knowledge on fitting, hands on fitting.
4314.
Is there any way it is going to improve the orthokeratology lens practice?
No, Jyoti, can you come up with the second question again?
Okay, probably we'll finish the first question. I'll repeat the second.
Okay, the first question was who can practice orthokeratology?
Yeah, since you mentioned
any optometrist. Yeah, any optometrist who's well versed in fitting RGP contact lenses can practice orthokeratology. Now, if you're asking from the legal standpoint, I don't know. Because I've got 3 letters from the Government of India written on RTI. One says contact lenses cannot be fitted by an optometrist. One says contact lens can be fit by an optometrist. And one says super specialty contact lenses can only be fit by a postgraduate optometrist.
Okay.
So there is a confusion. So we don't know.
Okay. Maybe once the government clears the bill, we will have a better understanding.
Okay.
So probably the second question, the person who asked the question, they really want to hear a yes from you. Probably you say yes. Probably you can give your own answer also. So especially the student point of view, the learning of RGP lens fitting becoming fading day by day. Probably this can be a prerequisite to fit ortho-K or not.
Yes. learning RGB contact lens definitely is a prerequisite for fitting orthokeratology lenses. And with respect to students, remember I showed you the last slide, Sudhanshu Dhanotia and Rishabh Gupta. Now I can tell you for sure that these people are better than me in fitting orthoke lenses. So I might get stuck, but they have answers just like that. So students can very easily learn. You should have that intent and you should understand a little bit about RGB contact lens fitting, and it's rest is all easy.
Okay, we understand. So, Savita, if you have any more questions, please go ahead.
Is there any difference between orthoke lenses and myopia control lenses? Is there really any difference?
There is only one difference. There is only one difference. The myopia control lenses have to be designed after taking into consideration the pupil diameter of the patient, because you want some amount of plus power to fall inside the pupil. Then only the myopia control effect is better. So that's the only difference. And another thing, for people who know a little bit about orthoke fitting, now for one diopter of myopia corrected, you generate a plus one power in the mid-periphery. And for effective myopia control, you need at least plus four power in the mid-periphery. So which means, if you're fitting a minus one person, and if you give a ready-made contact lens from your trial set, it is only generating plus one power in the mid-periphery, which is not sufficient for myopia control. It may be excellent for orthokeratology for cosmetic reason, but not for myopia control. Then you need to go on to your software, click few buttons, and make sure only minus one is corrected, but plus four is generated. And you can do that. So for powers below four, I would say custom designing would work better. For powers beyond four, then your regular orthokeratology lenses may work as good myopia control lenses.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, and it depends, and it, there is a difference with the different companies also, right?
Yeah, of course, yes.
The design will be different. When
you're ordering a lens with any company, and if you're allowing them to design the lens for you, it will be always helpful if you give the age of the patient and if you clearly specify that this is for cosmetic correction or this is for myopia control. And they will make those necessary changes in the lens.
Okay, fine. Lots and lots of questions are getting loaded, sir, but I think we are... almost,
I know South is full of all intellectual people. You know, never before so many questions have been asked. But if the questions are unanswered, you can always connect with me on email and I'll be happy to guide you there.
Okay, sir. Can you repeat your email ID once, sir, so that people will... Because there is a spelling.
Yeah, it's Y-E-S-H-W-A-N-T.
Why not you just show it on the screen where people can note down?
I think your inbox will be loaded with questions now.
So you can get my spelling here. It's yashwantsauji@hotmail.com. Or I can even type it here.
Better type it.
Is that okay?
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Fine, sir.
So I hope this talk was useful, and I hope at least 5% of the people who've been listening to this talk would come into orthokeratology.
Sure, sir. Definitely. And, it is exciting
and
also.
And Pungode, there is one thing that I would like to share. Whenever I used to meet Mr. Lal, he always used to say, one day, you know, we will call you people here, the Masterclass Optometry team, and we will conduct a program for the OATN members. And unfortunately, today he is not there, but the program finally happened. Although only I am there, Nilesh is not there. But on this day, I'm missing him, and I'm missing my, godfather, Rajni Turakhia, who expired just a couple of months back. Who actually meant everything to me. And that is, his house is one of the reasons why I keep coming back to Chennai every now and then. So Chennai has given so much for me. So I'm happy I could give back a little bit.
you had a superb, the session was very good actually.
Thank you.
I now invite Dr. Jyothi Balaji to give a thank you note.
Hey, sorry, Ashwin. Whatever I'm going to say, don't take it other way. But when we discuss, there are group of optometrists. We discuss, take time and discuss what topic need to be assigned in our iTeach program. When we discussed, when I suggested your name and the topic, everybody is accepted and truly saying you didn't let us down. You actually delightfully given so much because when you approach science, okay, you got so many avenues to learn. Okay, you got a resource of online, you got people, if you write to them, you can attend a training program. But somebody who builds the practice from the scratch, okay, from the scratch, sharing his experience is worthwhile to go through. So we thought that would be very, very essential to bring it to people because people now they got so much time. They are thinking, okay, what they want to refine or redesign their clinic. Probably we thought this would be the best one to give back. And you have done a fantastic job of sharing every single aspect. If suppose somebody go back and see your video, they will get everything and they can customize what they want to do it. Like how do you reach out to a patient? From your database is very important. You've shown the electronic medical record. You also shown the paper-based record, informed consent. Though it has got a lot of other commercial aspect. This is very much needed because you cannot do anything without commercial, but commercial aspects are very, very much needed. If you remove those commercial aspects, you are given a very, very, very clean know-how, how to go from scratch. I think that is very, very clean. And we from OATN, we will remain ever thankful to you. On this platform, I would request you to come back, okay, for the second session, where we talk only the science.
Oh my God. Thank you.
We will talk like a case where exactly you have done the modification, various things, and how, suppose somebody is an independent practitioner, how he has to take care of the science side of it. Probably I'll request you to consider, we will approach you in near future, and definitely. And what we really appreciate you is taking every single question meticulously, answering it, okay, and you are making sure everything is answered. Thank you so much, and I on behalf of OATN we thank you again, and we also thank Savita, who has done a wonderful job by moderating.
Thank you, sir,
4 hours before, get trained, make sure every setting is taken care. And the event is went so smooth, okay? And
thank
what
you, sir. Thanks a lot.
Is the pav bhaji. Probably we need to think, is there any way we can supply by sitting at their home, how they can have pav bhaji at the same time they listen to you?
I know, it was very tempting, right?
Very tempting.
So thank you for the kind words.
Thank you, and
my apologies again for joining in a bit late, but it was unavoidable.
No problem. Please take care. Family is always first.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
The
wonderful listeners in our YouTube, we thank you. All this is possible because so much interest you are showing it. Thank you very much. Thanks a lot.